Okay, friends.
As you know, you've got 15 minutes to present. After your presentation, you'll have a seat and we'll ask you questions. You can start now.
Good afternoon, professors. I am here to present you before you the effect of willingness to communicate with a native and non-native teacher of English. My name is Francisco Muñoz, and the advisor of this research was Professor Diwak. I'm going to start with the context. This research took place in Escuela Benjamín Vicuña Mackenna, which is located in Santiago. The course that I select was the 7th grade, and the teachers that I had was a non-native teacher who was the tutor teacher of my internship, and a native teacher who was sent by the PIAL, Programa Inglesa de Puertas, from the Ministry of Education, with the purpose of develop the communicative language teaching that the English curriculum proposed to the English program in all the country. The idea of having a native teacher was to develop the communicative skills of learners, and I had the opportunity to observe how was the native teacher and the non-native teacher classes. The statement of the research problem. Well, as I said before, I was really interested about a native teacher doing classes because I have never had one. So for me it was kind of attractive. However, when I had to identify a research problem, I noticed that the attitude from learners was different with the native teacher in contrast with the non-native teacher. As you can see here, in the class with the non-native teacher, students knew that the non-native teacher eventually was going to speak in Spanish. So she avoided a lot of English situations that she could face. And in the case of the native teacher, she uses a lot of English. Actually, she did the whole classes in English, and the students communicate in English as well. The only like difference it has was in the teaching, in the learning process. The students have some grammatical mistakes or mistakes about vocabulary. But the communicative language teaching, that is the method that is used in this program, doesn't affect at all because the main purpose is to communicate. I have to mention that as I saw these reactions from the students, willingness to communicate arose from this, and I create the purpose of the study to determine if a native or a non-native teacher of English influences learners' willingness to communicate. The general objective about this research was to determine a possible influence of the native or non-native teacher on the learner's willingness to communicate to perform speaking activities. And the hypothesis was a native teacher will increase or affect the learner's willingness to communicate in their speaking activities performance. The description of sources. In the theoretical outlook, I have two references. Brain in 2013 says that there is no significant difference between one teacher to another teacher, a native or a native teacher. They can provide the same tools in an equal way. And Natasha Angolani in 2015, quote, my entire in 1998 about willingness to communicate as a disposition of speech in a certain specific time into certain specific people in general using a tool. So I have this and the other one to contrast, and I can conclude that the teacher have the tool to provide to the students, and they can integrate that tool to have the ability to communicate and to express their ideas. In the empirical point of view, Saranapalli in 2014 claimed that the expected advantages of willingness to communicate for success in language make it worthwhile for language teachers to know about its contrast, the variable affecting it, and the possible ways to help to facilitate. This supports the idea of having, of what I said before, about having two teachers to provide willingness to communicate, and both can equally provide this tool for learners. In a political point of view, and ending with the description of the sources, Millenbeek stated in 2012, teachers have to use material, didactic strategies, and activities that fit to the distinctive cultural and ethnic features of the students and their interests. In this research, it was the contact with a native teacher who is who has English spoken language for their mother tongue was really distinctive to a non-native teacher that was inserted in a language that doesn't speak English all the time. So in this point, the distinctive cultural and ethnic feature was provided by the native teacher. The methodology. Well, this research was a positive, has a positive paradigm, and the approach was in table of numbers, which is a quantitative approach. The procedure of the material. Well, because of the tutor-teacher was not an organized person, we have to make like an agreement to the day of the application, the application of the material, and we have to schedule a day available for both teachers, because the content that the teacher, the tutor teacher, was watching with the students was not the same with the native teacher. So I have to be with both of them. And the application of the material with both teachers, it means that in the presence of both teachers, because I was watching the willingness to communicate from learners. The population sample method. 30 students for 7th grade was the whole sample, and I used the inter-class method. Maggie and Gus in 2005 postulated in second language research. We often need to use interclasses for our study, and in these cases, the participants cannot be randomly assigned to one of the experimental or control groups. Interclasses are commonly and often by necessity used in research for the sake of convenience. I used this method because it was a very small population that I didn't have to select some of people because it was not necessary. And the research material applied was a Nagafin and Golovin's willingness to communicate checklist. The analysis, the technique that I used for the analysis of the data were two, a pair t-test and a cohesion D, sorry. Well, here is the technique for a student. Here is graded by a Likert scale from 1 to 5. And here are the 9 statements to be observed. The consideration of trustworthiness. This is a very important part because the internal validity wants to cover the contents from the checklist, and it was designed based on willingness to communicate theory developed by my entire class all in 1998, and the cover and the contents covered in the checklist was willingness, was confidence, was feelings, and was attitude. That was the contents. In the case of external validity, it was a seventh grade from a EFL classroom, a public school, and the external validity can put in into other contexts with the same educational environment. The objectivity says control sample. It means that the researcher, when he was doing, he was applying the material, had any kind of contact with the sample and with the teacher. And reliability, this material was previously used in an EFL classroom also, and the Cronbach alpha coefficient calculated was 0.4094. It means that has a strong internal consistency. The findings. As you can see here, the willingness to communicate in order to perform tasks with a native teacher is this. The vertical, the horizontal numbers are the statements, and the vertical numbers are the bigger scale rating. And here is a native teacher. Here is a non-native. Here is a native teacher. You can see that there is a difference between both of them. Here is a presentation of discussion and findings. A t-test paired to test paired two sample means a paired t-test was used here because the paired t-test, what it is looking for is to have one variable to contrast with other variables. So both of them are going to be like matched, and they're going to give you a result. There is a difference between one to another. And Cohen's D, it was of 2.0. So it means that the Cohen's D, the measure to measure the size of effect was very significant. In the fulfillment of research hypothesis, I could say that a native teacher of English increases the learner's willingness to communicate to perform speaking activities. The limitation of the study was a lack of time, but this was due to the activities by the tutor teacher and the tutor teacher absence. I have to mention, because what I have to face in that situation was to be like the professor when the teacher was not there, so the rigorous steps that research takes couldn't be done like in a complete way. So I have to be focused on the practical sometimes more than the research stuff. The contribution of findings, the predictive knowledge. What I could see and face was to capture the levels of willingness to communicate from learners with different teachers was necessary two variables to be analyzed. In this case, if I hadn't had one of these variables, I could not take this research as complete as it is, because both of them have to be to notice the difference. The future direction of this research, an EFL context along with a native teacher, because in Chile we don't have a native teacher in all the schools, is really, it's not something that is common to see. And take the application more than once, just for having like a concrete result of the material. Finally, the metacognitive analysis. I'm going to focus on seminar, develop tasks as in the work in the process of doing a research, taking the steps necessary to develop the research, and using the person to be committed to the work of a researcher. And in the practicum, attending to the student's need. Sometimes, or all the time, happens that the students have different levels, so me as a teacher have to face that and level them to be like a hence between both theaters. And the strengths, weaknesses, and challenges, I have to say that appropriate attitude to a lesson and encourage the learner was something that in Peter regular classes was always mentioned, that we have to do positive reinforcement and positive statement because of, or to avoid fear from students, and the idea was to communicate. The weakness, time management, because I couldn't have a team like the time provided for the lesson, sometimes because of the teacher activities. And in last point, the challenge, being pathetic with adolescents and leaving tasks for last minutes before delivery. That is something that in this primary level, you know, or in my previous three internships that I did before, I knew how to face that situation. But in this case, to be with adolescents, it could be different because of the things that they are leading, the things that they are changing, the things that they are facing, that is completely different from primary. And these are the references used in this presentation, and this was my research. Thank you very much.
Thank you.